Like I said, we've been here and we've been together in the field of journalism for the past 30, 40 years. Never thought that we would be sitting at a time when we are going to face what journalists have been facing for the past 1 year in particular and before that as well. The law of sedition, which of course should have been abolished a long while ago, has been used recklessly to intimidate and harass journalists doing their job. All of us who have been in the field, who have covered conflict, who have traveled, who have been on the road, and not just in the studios, know that it is possible to make errors, though in this case I don't think there was an error maybe, but to report when you are relying on eyewitnesses and you are reporting violence, and you're reporting maybe it could be the civil war in Assam in the 80s, it could be the violence against Sikhs in Delhi in the 80s, it could be communal carnage in UP and Bihar, casteist carnage. You know that in the field you are relying on eyewitness accounts. Now with television and a mic, you rush to report, you retract, you can make a mistake. You might not make a mistake, but then to be faced with sedition, to be told that you can be arrested any moment and locked away without a hearing, this is only being done to intimidate, harass, victimize the journalists against whom these cases are being filed, but also to terrorize the professionals as well, to make you think twice, to make you afraid of doing your job, to be worried every time you write, to be looking over your shoulder, and for then, of course, the editors and the proprietors and those who control the news to be very reluctant in reporting the news as it is and to bring truth to power. And this is the entire reason for what we are seeing. A Facebook post gets three journalists charged in the Northeast. A tweet here and there, you get sedition charges against you. And it is a constant, it is almost constant that somehow the message is shut up. Stop writing. Stop bringing truth to power. Stop being a watchdog of democracy. Stop speaking for the poor and the victimized. Speak for the powers, speak for government, speak for the establishment, speak for us, but don't speak for the toiling masses of this country. I think this is really the message that is coming out. We are so glad that so many journalists still believe in the profession and know that for democracy to survive, the fourth pillar of democracy also has to be vibrant, has to be passionate and courageous, it has to be irreverent, it has to be honest. And this is what we will all, we hope we will all strive together to do. Thank you.